So the National Robotarium has been set up by the UK government and the Scottish government to grow the economy around robotics and AI. And the traction we've had so far and the interest that we're seeing is really encouraging.
We have lab space, we have lots of breakout areas, and everything's modular so we can change it. We can do whatever we want here, essentially. It's a playground for robotics.
Robotics and AI has got huge potential, particularly around healthcare and social care.
We have had organisations approach us about mocking up a hospital room, and it means that we can hopefully take our healthcare staff possibly out of dangerous situations if we had another pandemic, say, and we can deploy robots to clean a hospital space or provide some non-human care within a hospital setting.
The passive design of the building follows a double skin facade. So facing south, you have 141 glass panels. It creates a buffer zone between the building and the Scottish cold temperatures. So throughout that, it generates heat within it that can be then distributed throughout the building to reduce its heating consumption. So what we're seeing here is the robot dog that we coordinated with the university to bring onto site. What this allows us is, through the use of the LiDAR scanner's camera, to generate a 3D mapping of the construction progress and spot any potential clashes before they become an issue on site.
The building went up over a couple of years, and that included most of the time during COVID. And that brought a lot of issues with it in terms of supply of labour and supply of materials. But there was always the desire by the Robertson's team to push on and get things done. And I saw them innovate and be creative about how they'd solve problems and work around things. You could argue that they didn't have to have that drive, but they did. And they seemed very vested in making sure that Heriot-Watt and Edinburgh University got the National Robotarium that they wanted. So that was great.